The Netflix series Hollywood has led a lot of people to ask how much of it is actually true. Well, I hate to tell you that a lot of it is totally revisionist. Wave a magic wand and poof, homophobia and racism completely vanishes. But there is some truth in their portrait of Anna May Wong, played by Michelle Cruciak.
You don't have to make me look Asian. I already am Asian.
In the wake of this series, and because it's APA Heritage Month, I thought I would offer an essential Anna May Wong, which also gives an insidious glimpse into the racism of Hollywood's golden years. Anna May Wong was a style icon, and she was pretty much the only Asian-American film actress of renown from the 1910s to the 1950s. She was born in 1905 in Los Angeles, and she was actually third generation. Her family had been in California since 1855. It's interesting to note that the Spanish influenza might have played a decisive role in her life. She is quoted as saying, "All the schools were closed because of the epidemic, so she gathered up all of her change and went and saw her very first movie." From then on, she was obsessed with films. In 1922, at the age of 17, she got her first big break, the lead role in The Toll of the Sea, which was essentially an adaptation of the Madame Butterfly story. You know, lovely Asian flower falls for a big American galoof. He knocks her up, goes back to the US, forgets all about her. He comes back with white wifey in tow. Fragile Asian blossom, give him baby, commit suicide. But it's one of the first Technicolor films, and it's beautiful. It's also interesting to note that this film was written by Frances Marion, who was a pioneer woman screenwriter, because there actually were a lot of women in early filmmaking. 2 years later, Douglas Fairbanks picks Anna May Wong for the role of a Mongol slave in his lush fantasy, The Thief of Baghdad. After that, Anna May Wong bumped around in Hollywood playing Eskimos, Native Americans, evil dragon ladies, and worst of all, second fiddle to white women in yellowface. In 1928, she had enough and went off to Europe. First, she hit Berlin, where she made three films, all of which are largely unwatchable. And then she went to London, where she made an amazing film called Piccadilly. You can see it now on BFI in a beautiful new print with a horrible soundtrack. I highly suggest that you just turn off the sound and play Duke Ellington instead. Piccadilly starts off in a fancy nightclub where an inebriated diner played by Charles Laughton finds a dirty plate. This leads to one of the best character introductions in a film. One of the biggest pleasures in Piccadilly is that it gives a glimpse of 1920s London, and it's also incredibly astute in the way it lays bare racial tensions in this particular scene. Thank you. Anna May Wong returned to America in 1930, ready to take on talkies after receiving elocution lessons in Cambridge. She signed on to Paramount and made her most famous film, Shanghai Express.
It took more than one man to change my name to Shanghai Lily.
Marlene Dietrich plays world-weary grifter Shanghai Lily, who boards an ill-fated train and ends up in a compartment with another grifter, Hui Fei, played by Anna May Wong. The sisterhood in this film is amazing.
I heard your gramophone, ladies, and thought I'd come in and get acquainted, if you don't mind.
Not at all. Come in.
It's a bit lonely on a train, isn't it? I'm used to having people around. They put my dog in the baggage car. That's why I dropped in on you. I've been visiting my niece in Pekin. She married a seafaring man. He hasn't been home in 4 years, and she ain't been very cheerful. I have a boarding house in Shanghai. Yorkshire pudding is my specialty, and I only take the most respectable people.
Don't you find respectable people terribly dull?
You're joking, aren't you? I've only known the most respectable people. You see, I keep a boarding house.
What kind of a house did you say?
A boarding house.
Oh.
I'm sure you're very respectable, madam.
I must confess I don't quite know the standard of respectability that you demand in your boarding house, Mrs. Haggerty.
Shanghai Express was nominated for Best Picture, Best Director, and it won for Best Cinematography. But Anna May Wong found herself continuing to battle miscegenation. She decamped for a vaudeville tour in the UK and only returned to Hollywood to campaign for the part of Olan in Pearl Buck's The Good Earth. As portrayed in the series Hollywood, she didn't get the part. Her disappointment led to her going on her one and only trip to China in 1936, where she learned that she was also an outsider. Here's a glimpse of her in a 1937 Hollywood variety show, which gives a little glimpse into what she had to put up with.
At sound of gong, it will be exactly time to present China Lady of Fashion, Anna May Wong.
I've just returned to Hollywood after a most marvelous year in China, my first visit to the ancestral country. All the Chinese ladies look so smart and vivid in the beautiful modern dress of China. And being feminine, it made a deep impression on me, not to mention my pocketbook. I could not resist to go completely Chinese in my wardrobe. Here's an afternoon dress in the famous Peking blue from the former capital, now called Beijing. The cape is a blending of the very old with the new. The material is tribute brocade from the Imperial Palace, made up along the latest Western lines.
I'm sorry, but I only understand Cantonese.
Oh, I thought I could brush up on my Mandarin. The dress is from Beijing, the famous Imperial yellow with the dragon, a symbol of old China.
After returning to Hollywood, Anna May Wong was in a string of B-movies at Paramount Pictures. But there was actually a silver lining to being in B-movies. Because they weren't as well publicized, Wong was able to play roles that weren't as stereotypical. She even played roles that didn't die a tragic death. In King of Chinatown, she's a surgeon who nurses a Chinatown racketeer back to health. And in Daughter of Shanghai, she's paired with Korean-American actor Philip Ahn, making this one of the only Hollywood golden era films with two Asian-Americans playing lead roles. In the film, there's even a happy ending for her character.
How would you like to live in Washington?
Perhaps a change of climate is just what I need.
Then it's settled.
Does that mean you're asking me to marry you?
Ma.
Note that she speaks Toysonese, and she probably had to coach Philip on in Toysonese as well. But she still doesn't get that screen kiss. I'll leave you with a song that was supposedly written about Anna May Wong after an affair in London.
A cigarette that bears a lipstick's traces, an airline ticket to romantic places, and still my heart has wings. These foolish things remind me of you. A tinkling piano in the next apartment, those stumbling words that told you what my heart meant.